Hey folks, we're back. And it hasn't been very long either. So far, we've managed to rebuild our entire... Whoop, there's a guy right over there. We'll just sit back. Sneak back down and look. What are they after anyway? Oh, they're taking metal. Probably can hear me. I don't really care. I'm not after the metal anyway. Where are y'all going? Oh, wait, they went down. Kind of want to watch these guys a little bit and see what happens. I don't have a dang spyglass on me, so I don't know if these are the guys that I'm at that were attacking us or what. They probably don't know they're being watched, so they may. Okay, let's move down here just in case something stupid happens. Man, I don't know. Dang, I should have got a spyglass ready. But I can at least watch if they fly off. Okay, they're flying off. Which direction are they going? Alright, they're flying that way. So more than likely, they're flying as straight as they possibly can. There we go. Okay. If that's who I think it is, we may have an idea of where their base is, and that'll give me a reason to go F them up real fast. Anyway, folks, I'm Badger Wild. This is Ark Survival Evolved. And I'm checking this place out a little bit. See what all they took. It looks like they mined the mountain pretty heavily. Whoever it was, they know where a lot of the metal is, which I don't really care. But I'm gonna mine me some as well. I may end up having to work at night. Ah, they figured out where all the heavy metal nodes are. That's what they're hitting. Or they figured out where some of them are. Anywho. Yeah, I'm gonna need to... Let's get some amara berries, some good stuff. Take some rocks back with me. If they start the attack, I'm just going to tell them, no, I'm day shift. I don't know what's going on here. So apparently they are mining the place out. They may have already hit the base. They may not know that I'm here. Which puts me in a situation, because if I start smelting metal, I could lose all the metal I've currently got. Let's just throw some crap in here real quick. See what happens between now and then. Right now, I've got to get my adobe back up and running. I'm going to grab this spark powder I just got, because it is going to be so easy for me to get my hands on. I need to get that. I need to get that other stuff, but I should probably get the adobe up and running. They may not realize I'm on if it is the guys that attacked us. So, for some of y'all that are wondering what happened, we recently got raided by a group of guys. We had T-Rexes and a bunch of other good stuff. I mean, I was really impressed by Jade taking the initiative, getting us some nice, nice stuff. And somebody came along and destroyed all of it. So... My thing as of right now, I do want some armor. At least that, and some desert cloth shoes, that'll help. More of that. Of course, the spark powder doesn't weigh a whole lot, so it's easy for me to just get this stuff and hang on to it. They may think they've wiped us and we're gonna leave, but eh, that's not happening. I have news for them. That ain't happening. Not today. So they've come by and they apparently raided my mountain of some metal. Some metal, I might add. Some metal. Not all metal. They're probably going to go back to their place and smelt it all. But I know where they're, I know what direction they came from. So, I mean, I'm pretty sure. I need a spyglass. I need a spyglass in case they come back and I happen to catch them. I need to set up a position because obviously they're going to come back. I'm pretty sure of that. Let's go get some crystal. Figure out where they are, and I may just be building a gun here in the next couple episodes and shooting that Argy of theirs. Let them know they can be touched. Crap, I took a crystal. Interesting. Interesting. Not illogical, but it is interesting. Alright, there we go. Don't need a lot of crystal, just a little bit. So we'll head back down to the base. I don't really want to stay out here and just watch for these guys constantly, but if I can get me a spyglass up and running, I can catch them. I might be able to figure out who it is. I think it's the two guys that's been attacking us. If that be the case, I can run up there and I can get them real fast. Well, I may not be attacking them, but what I will probably be doing is watching their every move for a bit. And I might hunt them down. That's just a faster way of doing it, guys. Alright. Alright, let's see. How much? Do I have any more silk? No, I think that's what I ran out of, was silk. Okay, I gotta figure out something to do with the spark pattern. I can rebuild the spark pattern anytime. It's not difficult. So we're just gonna drop that. Alright, there we go. And I want to head up here because I want to see where these guys are going. Because they're getting metal. I want to know where they're, who they are. Because if they're who I think they are, Vengeance could be pretty close to them. I just had my stupid spyglass on me. I know who they were. They moved off that direction. So it's a safe bet that they're coming back. Apparently they mine most of the mountain for metal, so I'm hoping they will try to come back at some point. They may have hit most of the high metal. I can't sit here all day. I'm gonna stop right here and I'm just gonna wait. If they come back, I'm gonna turn the game back on. If they don't, then I'm gonna head off and do something else because we still gotta get our base up and running. So I'll see you guys here in just a minute. So yeah, folks, I finally gave up on it. It's been about 2 hours. And I'm dehydrating and I need water, so gotta get work done. I can't sit around here and wait on these guys to come back. They did take a good chunk of metal off the mountain. I'm hoping they leave here before long so I can take my metal, I can haul off and get more metal. I am gonna do some checking though around the mountain. I'm looking here and it doesn't appear that they've hit some of the other nodes, so I probably have the option of getting some metal myself. I think they probably are like most people, run up the side of the mountain and didn't realize there was metal on it in certain places. But anyway, let's head down here. Yep, this big nugget's sitting there as well. So I don't have to worry about my metal or anything like that at the moment. Plus, in about 2 days, it'll all come back anyway, and I can start... I can take the current amount of ingots that I've got and get some cementing paste together. I need to get that done first off. But, oh wait, I got this thing. I also have to get some food together. So I can go back and finish repairing the base. problems. First off, I gotta get our water back up and running. Because our water is very, 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 very important. And someone hitting that has really, 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 really put us behind on that nonsense. We have a Pegomastix. He's like, you come near me, bub, I'm going to smack you with this whip real fast. Just go away. Ain't worth it. Okay, so first off, I need... Before I go anywhere, I need some dadgum sand. Okay. I don't need the stone, so... That's a no need. And I guess the next thing I need after this... Well, first off, I need to eat this. Alright. Health is steadily going up. I've got wood. I've got thatch. I've got fiber back at the base. Thanks to that little raid I did today. And let's see. What else? All I need to do is get some of this cactus sap together. Make myself a ton of adobe. Rebuild the door. Alright, there we go. There's 90 of that. So that should be more than enough to get from point A to point B. Then I need to get 50... I need 50 metal ingots forged up so I can get my sword back up and running again. Which would be nice to have that again. Then I need... I'm betting those are those guys. I need to go find them at some point. That may be a mission in itself. To go out, look for them, and see where their crap is at. Because if I go find them and I take them out, I'm pretty sure I know where their base is. They're forging metal off here. I need to go wipe them. And that'll stop them from attacking us at the very least. And I want to wipe them in such a way they don't know who it is. I also want to get some of my tools back. Because I'm pretty sure that's what they've been mining with. They've been mining with my tools and just been taking our metal and stuff. What little we have. They came over and attacked our stuff. I almost wonder if... There's not some idiot passing a rumor around. Because you have to think about this stuff. When you're being attacked constantly like this. You have to think. Is there some idiot out there... attacking our base or passing around rumors saying we're like raiding everybody, which in reality we don't have a big base at all. So I don't know what all they would be considering. Even if the base gets wiped, I pretty much decided, me and Jade, if the base gets wiped, what we're gonna do is we're gonna head out to the desert and we'll just build out there, build up our strength, and then the plan is to crush the Alpha at some point. I mean, I'm not stupid in thinking that we're going to be able to just live here peacefully with everyone. I want to take out the Alpha because I want to be Alpha. And me and Jade talked about it a while back. And at first I was like, well, let's see what we can get by with. And now with everything that's happened, I realize now the only way that we're going to guarantee our survival to some extent... is to be Alpha. It is the only way. Alright. Crap is getting repaired. Repaired that. Anything else need to be repaired? Alright, let's head outside and see what all needs to be repaired here. Repair that. Repair that. I need to repair this bed also. I gotta keep everything repaired and up. Otherwise, we could end up losing a lot. Okay. No. I want to repair you. There we go. Okay, repaired everything. I just have to craft a new door. Oh, what'd I do? Structures, adobe, door. There now. There we go. Now that's all fixed. Let's see if old Badger can't make himself his some gloves, because I don't have any gloves. I need gloves. I has no gloves. There we are. There we go. All right, we got some gloves. Let's access inventory here. I got 87 metal in that. I've got my base somewhat up and running. I need a sword in order to get the cementing paste I need to rebuild our water supply, or at least get it going again. I don't understand. I think what they did was they probably kited up a rock golem, and that's what's probably destroyed most of our stuff. But I need... What do I need? I need metal, number one. So we're going to have to go get us about 100 metal to make the sword with. And then once I get all this stuff figured out... What is this? What over here? What is this? Okay, that's Quetzal Land. I don't have a problem with Quetzal Land. Let's just watch here for a minute and see what happens. A lot of people using this mountain. A lot of people using this mountain. Alright, please tell me. He's not flying off. He's heading this way. Well, I ain't got a problem with you, dude, so whatever. Something I'm interested at the moment. And he is sacking the rest of the metal too. Man. What's he after? There's no metal right there. Where are you going? Interesting to just watch and see people move around. He's keeping a wide berth from my base to some extent. I don't know why. Levels on Dragon 168. Well, if you didn't build all over your damn metal nodes, you wouldn't have a problem now, would you? Okay. Let's see where he goes now. I don't know. Does he know where that one metal node is? He may be heading towards it. What just happened? Where'd he go? I don't think he took all the metal. I don't think he did. Let me see here. I don't think he took it all. There should be some right over here. Yeah, he missed a bunch. Yeah, that big nugget right there is still sitting. He may have just took off. Battery's full up. Okay, first things first. We need to hit this big metal node here. Make sure he don't come back and take more crap from me. Fun times. May talk to Jade. It may be time for us to just turn this base into a small smelter zone and just head out. Adgum, do I have to get over 200 metal out of this thing? Come on. I didn't need that much. At least not right now, at least. I toss that. I wonder. I need to sneak away, because the moment this guy realizes that I'm here, he's gonna kill me off for the metal that I've currently got on me. I also need to get this base done, but I need to get our water back up, and I think what I'm probably gonna do, I've been avoiding it, but I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna replace it with metal water reservoirs, because technically that would be a lot easier. And that'll kind of be a thumb in the eye to some extent to whoever destroyed that stuff, because then they'll be looking at it like, oh wait, come on now. How'd you guys do this all of a sudden? Which really, I need to get metal pipes going if I'm going to do that nonsense. Oh well. Alright, let's take this out for a minute. If I separate this and run all three forges simultaneously. Ah, there we go. This way, if this guy comes back and comes after me, I can just look there and say, nah, I had some metal tools left over. Listen, I had some metal tools left over. I'm just trying to build up some spark powder for when the metal respawns. Right now, it's a battle for flint. I need spark powder. Bad. Bad. The thing is, if me and Jade can get us a base somewhere away from these idiots, there's a lot of metal off that way. I want to start building a base out there, but we don't have the resources at the moment, or we can't maintain the resources at least, to get out there and get a base started. It's going to have to take me, Jade, maybe JP, and a couple of good flyers flying equipment out there and just building a small platform for me to operate with first. And then I can start building all kinds of stuff out there in the good old-fashioned desert. Let's check that deal here. Some of your buildings are preventing me from building. Please, can we ally? It's always a good idea. It's always a good idea to check the deal here every so often. I don't know, I guess they're all building in the obelisks or some nonsense, which is kind of dumb. I think that's where everybody is. I think that's where all the alliances are building bases at, is over in the one area. They're just pissed at us because we're kind of like loners. We're doing our own thing. Which doesn't bother me. I mean, it just means that I know where they all are. But that would make sense, though. Wait a minute. That would make a lot of sense. Okay, guys, hear me out just a minute. Just had an epiphany. That makes a lot more sense than... Dang it. Here, let me turn down the gamma a bit so you guys can see what I'm looking at. Or see what I know. Right there is the green obelisk. And the obelisks are one of the easiest places to get resources and water. And I was over here at Red Obelisk, and there was a lot of people here. French flag, bunch of French guys. I wonder if that's where our raiders are coming from, if they're all consolidating at those obelisks because they've got water and pearls and everything else. If that be the case, man, those guys are screwed because I know where they are now. Hmm. I know what those guys over there are thinking, though. Dadgum group of guys, chaos, order. They just won't leave the server. I am learning some crap here. Okay, everything's gonna be a little darker because I set down the gamma a bit. Which is acceptable in my opinion. Okay, let's power up some spark powder here. Won't take much. Get these forges running. Get myself... Ooh, I got another floor I gotta fix. Alright, I just gotta get some stuff together. Get my cementing paste going. What will it take to make metal pipes? That'd probably be a lot easier. Well, once the base is destroyed, they'll just destroy it and go on. So, I mean, there's not really much of a point. Okay, I'm safe in this building as long as I don't move around too much. Okay, I got 91 metal in this one. 87 metal in that one. And 92 metal in that one. So... I can do this. I can get my equipment back. The problem is, man, this rebuilding equipment crap that keeps happening. Keeps causing me problems. And they are throwing a fit at us about crap that we're doing over here, and I'd just rather just them talk to us for a minute because... Dear God. Okay, that was me. I thought I heard footprints outside. Anyway, this pick is about worn out. I need to fix it real fast. Some quick repair work. Alright, I need to readjust the gamma too while I'm at it. I do like running my gamma kind of hot. Helps me see better. Helps me see more crap. Okay, so what are we doing in here? We have... Oh, how come that didn't go? Okay. Throwing some spark powder in there. Throwing some spark powder in there. I mean, one of the good things about us working is we can work at night. I don't have to worry about too much. Oh, that's annoying. Keep listening for people to attack us. Anyway, our main plan was to build a base up in the far... Let me just pull the map out here. We're either building a base in the far corner up by 10, or we're going to build something. I would like to build something over by 90-10. But that's putting us, both those locations are putting us pretty close. There's not a location here that's not going to put me, I don't think, in the path of one of the other tribes. I don't know very many flat spots. Like I said, I have to get a flyer first and fly out there when I'm not doing anything. And I'm putting all my energy into the base, pretty much. Trying to get it done and get everything finished. It's a wonderful time. Wonderful time to be badger. Okay. While the heat's going, most people will be down for the moment. And my adobe floor here apparently needs to be fixed. This adobe ceiling does, because I keep throwing grenades at it. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to sit back for a moment. Well, let's check something out here real fast. I need to know... I don't have enough hide. That's bad. because if I can't get my sword up and running, I'm going to be in some serious trouble. So all this is going to be for nothing. I need to brave this heat a little bit, because we need water more than anything else. I can survive a couple days with the water all jacked up, but I need some hide. I definitely need some hide. I think I can leave the base for just a minute. I mean, there's a lot of people on at the moment, but I've managed to keep going. If worst case scenario, if worst comes to worst, most of these guys will be offline later tonight, and I'll just hit the server when they're off. That's how we've been getting a lot of our work on the base done. And if it... a rock formation up there looked like a building for a second. I still haven't figured out how to camouflage something to where it looks like... to where it looks like a base of something. Or just like a piece of the rock. And these guys are obviously going to keep raiding people in this area. But if we can get some flyers together and get our... and get a big base started in the desert, which is the big plan, we will be able to build... just for the heck of it, we'll be able to work on equipment and stuff. In other words, we'll be able to actually advance the base. Because right now, most of this has been us just fighting. And I think this is an idea that I wanted to, like, do the series differently. I wanted us to, like, really be doing some cool stuff. But this, I actually enjoyed this a lot better thinking about it, because one of the things that Jade has mentioned before is, he said, people don't have... I think most players who play Ark don't have an idea of just what it takes to get established on a game like this. You look at us right now, all the crap that we're fighting, both environment and other players, especially on PvP, they don't like us being on here at all. And I don't care if they like us being on here at all. I think we are probably some of the few English-speaking people, or at least English-cultured people on here. I say that because that's my first and only language is English at the moment. I can bounce around. I can bounce around Spanish a bit, but that's about the best I've got going for me at the moment. But I mean, these guys have been hammering us like crazy. I'm pretty sure they're hammering other people. And with any luck, we can probably get some guys to come online. Maybe eventually wipe them. That's my plan: is to find some people. See if we can find new players that are just starting out. Like, those guys over there would have been awesome to have gotten hold of, but they lock up that water well. And I know what's fixing to happen to them anyway. They're fixing to get wiped. So, I mean, if I do it real quick, it'd be quick and dirty. They'll understand what all they're up against. This guy here, I don't know if he's been raided or not. Los Chavaleros. Where is a Jerboa? Jerboas. Oh, this is going to be fun getting this hide. And then go back and find out my base has been raided. If that be the case, I'll just wait until tonight. Because then they'll be off and I can do whatever I want at that point. I can run around. Check out their bases a bit more. I really wish we had a flyer or some kind of fast tame that I could use to get from point A to point B. Because I've never actually been to the Green Obelisk before. Not once. And I would like to go over and check it out sometime. One good thing is people are not real a-holes on this game. There's something I could take out right there. Hi there, Mr. Whatever you are. I don't remember your name. It won't be important anyway. Oh, I got 15 hide off that thing. I think that's enough. I think that's what I need for the sword. So we'll just head back. I'll have to get some cementing paste, so probably what I'll do is I'll just make a big run and I'll hit all the cementing paste I can get. And then we may start slowly disabling these guys and breaking them down. We're going to do it. We need an army of guys to help us offline. In other words, a bunch of dudes who are playing online who can play late at night with me offline. What is that? Oh, there's that one bird. So, I mean, we haven't talked with them or anything. They see us. We don't really talk too much, but we did say something about the one guys, and they all kind of laughed at it. If we go in there and we remove Groot's family from that cave and we break through them, they're all going to be a little freaked out. So if I strike, I need to strike. We strike, we're going to have to strike quick and we're going to have to strike hard, which means probably a full-on wipe. Hi there. Who is that? I don't know if that's a wild dragon or not, but it looks like he's heading to my base. Just over here, and I just fell into a ravine real fast. Need to get close. I need to figure out what's going on real quick. Alright, who's this? Oh, it's coming from Red Planet. Not interested in the fight, dude. If you can hear me, I'm not interested. You got that big giant dragon over there, so. Besides, we don't raid anyone anyway. Seems like he's gonna come back here and pick a fight. Are you? No? Okay. Got a mic, man? Okay. Never mind.